Hello students, today we are going to deal about knitting, which is going to be the second largest manufacturing system of fabric. The content of our today's topic is like clothing, introduction, fabric forming techniques, the comparison between weaving and knitting, and then the history of knitting, hand knitting, then the growth of machine knitting, that reason for the growth of machine knitting, characteristics of knitted fabric yarn, classification of knitting, weft knitting, warp knitting, the difference between weft and warp knitting, the terms and principles of like weft knitting. Our first topic is clothing introduction. So clothing, which is the best and the important thing of our human life. There are three basic needs in our human life. One is food, shelter, and then clothing. Among these three things, clothing play a vital role. For this manufacturing of clothing, we are using fibers and textile. These two combined together call it as clothing actually. The why reason why we are going with the clothing a different textile material means, first the people they used for the textile material and clothing to protect our body, to cover our body. So what is the reason we need to protect our body? To protect our body from the environment, from the hazard activities, and then the weather conditions. So this is the main reason. So for the protection of these things, we need different fabric or different varieties of fabric we need. For the different varieties of fabric, we are going with the different fabric manufacturing system. So among these, the fibers which is going to be converted as a fabric, that is the micro material is going to be converted as a fabric. There are two major classifications here for the manufacturing of fabric system. First one is like major. The major system contains weaving and knitting. The minor system contains non-woven and braided fabric. So for these four manufacturing system, we are supplying the raw material. There are two varieties of raw material that can be supplied. One is fiber, another one is yarn. The fiber, from the fiber, the non-woven fabric can be manufactured. From the yarn, the woven fabric, knitted fabric, and then braided fabric, these three fabric can be manufactured. So among these four manufacturing system of our fabric, weaving play a vital role. So weaving is nothing but the basic principles of weaving is interlacement of warp and weft. So warp, the lengthwise yarn, weft, the perpendicular yarn which is going to be your warp, that is called as warp and weft. We are using two set of yarn, one is running like this, another one is running like this. So interlacement is nothing but warp which is going to be interlaced with your weft yarn, the weft, that is called as fill. So these two things create a compact structure, this is called as woven fabric. The next type is non-woven fabric. Non-woven fabric is nothing but we know that already fiber which is going to be the raw material. So for those raw material, with the help of those fibers, we are creating a mat like appearance. So those mat can be bonded and binded together by way of different binding technique and bonding technique like chemical bonding, mechanical bonding, thermal, and so on. So the next method is braided fabric. So braided fabric is nothing but it is like a interweaving principle, like a hair tie principle. That can be manufactured by two methods. One is a tubular fabric and another one is a flat fabric. The next method is called as knitting. What we are going to do? Knitting. So knitting is nothing but interlooping of yarn. So interlooping yarn is nothing but a single yarn like this. It can be interlooped like this. So the looping principle is applied over here. So this is called as interlooping of yarn. So before we enter the topic of our knitting, we must know that what are the difference between the major two classes of our fabric manufacturing system like weaving and knitting. So weaving, it's a very, very important topic. Knitting is also a very important topic. Both are play a vital role here for our fabric manufacturing system. For an example, we'll see the comparison between our weaving and knitting. We'll see one, first one, knitting. Knitting is nothing but interlacement of, like interlooping of yarn. Weaving is nothing but interlacement of yarn. For knitted fabric, a single yarn can be converted as a fabric. But in the case of woven fabric, that is called as weaving machine fabric, we need minimum two set of yarn, one is warp and weft. The next thing is, for knitted fabric, a single yarn means a cone can be converted as a knitted fabric. For in the case of weaving, we need a beam, we need a filler like weft yarn. So instead of for this purpose, weaving involve huge investment, but knitting have a less investment. Next, the thing is, because of these things, the productivity of our knitted fabric having high, the productivity of our woven fabric is low. Automatically, because of the productivity and then because of the like preparatory process which involved for weaving, the force of human is high in your weaving, the force of human is less in your knitting. Then coarser count is most probably used for knitted fabric, but in your woven fabric and weaving industries, any kind of material can be used. That is, either it may be fine or coarser, medium, anything can be possible according to the end uses. And then while we talk about the fabric particulars and then fabric characteristics point of view, it is like a looping of yarn, it is like a interlacement of yarn. So while go with the looping, automatically it is having an open structure. Here the structure is going to be very compact. So the permeability, like moisture permeability, it is having very high in your knitted fabric. Here the moisture permeability, moisture absorption, it will be very low. Automatically, again the looping concept play a vital role here. There is no, or there will be a way less crease resistance in your woven fabric, but here there is a high crease resistance in your knitted fabric. And then obviously thickness play a vital role. The thickness of the fabric in your knitted fabric is high. Here the thickness of the fabric in your woven fabric is low. And then no wrinkle. Knitted fabric don't have any wrinkle. Woven fabric create a lot of wrinkle because of the interlacement of yarn and then compact structure. And then knitted fabric having very good extensibility and very good recovery. We know that elastic character. Elastic character is nothing but, already I told you, like looping of yarn. So the loop that can be extended, and then while release the load of the loop, it will be recovered its original position. This is called as elasticity. The elasticity of the knitted fabric is very high, but in the case of your woven fabric, we have interlacement of warp and weft. Automatically there is no elasticity, or there will be very, very less elasticity when compared to our knitted fabric. So next concept is dimensional stability. So dimensional stability is nothing but because of the open structure and the looping of those yarn, knitted fabric having poor dimensional stability, but the woven fabric again compact structure creating very good dimensional stability. And then permeability, we have very high permeability in knitted fabric, less permeability in woven fabric. Automatically these character which will pull down or which will be increase the strength of the fabric. So already we know that woven fabric create high strength, knitted fabric create low strength. And then sharpness, while creating sharpness, so while you bend the fabric, we are not able to create sharpness because we know that there will be high crease resistance is there. But here, it will create a sharp fabric. The while fold the fabric, it will create sharpness. Then, any small damages which will be in your knitted fabric, automatically it will lead very serious problem. Say for an example, a minor defect in your woven fabric create a major defect in knitted fabric. For an example, I tell you, a hole in a woven fabric, it is not a big issue. It can be it can be rectified, but in the case of knitted fabric, any small hole, it is created a very serious problem. It created as a major defect. So any small damages in your woven knitted fabric create a lot of problem. That is total collapse of knitted fabric. But in the case of our woven fabric, it is not like that. So it is depends. The reason why these things are happen, it is depends upon the fabric character and the manufacturing system what we follow for woven fabric and knitted fabric. Now you came to know that the basic concept of knitted fabric. Now we enter the topic of history of knitting. So why the knitted fabric are developed? Where developed or where we got the knitted fabric? Actually, there is no prompt record for the development of knitted fabric. No one know where it came from. Someone say it is like before Christ, like Christ's birth. Someone say after that. Someone say it is from Egypt. Someone say it may not. So blindly or something we can confirm ourselves, knitted fabrics are developed before 8th century. So we conclude ourselves, knitted fabric, from the history we see, knitted fabrics are manufactured before 8th century. So why knitted fabrics are very famous even though those 8th century means only because of hand knitting. The knitted fabric that can be manufactured by way of hand knitting. Hand knitting is nothing but, it is very simple. By our manual knitting, by using two knitting needle, we can manufacture a knitted fabric. So that is the origin of our knitted fabric. From those needle, from those technique, from those concept, we developed our knitted fabric in stage by stage up to our modern, ultra modern, a fully automatic knitting machine. Okay, now we'll see one by one. So in the 14th century, there is a small frame which will be developed by the person. So that will be used for a needle. Then 16th century, a gentleman, and his name is called as William Slee. Actually, he is the father of our knitting machine. Why we say he is the father of our knitting machine means he is the first person introduced a beard needle. Actually, he created or manufactured one stocking frame, that is manufactured with the help of wooden frames, and he used one beard needle placed in the horizontal direction. So those beard needle, like it approximately the cage of the machine is around 6 to 8 or 6 to 10. With those needle, he manufactured a silk fabric. Actually, that day it was very famous with the wool fabric, wool knitted fabric. He is the first person created a silk fabric, and then he is the first person he manufactured a machine particularly for knitting or knitted fabric actually. But there is a heavy opposition from the hand knitters, because in England there is a very famous in hand knitting, but he is the person he introduced machine knitting. So because of the controversy and that so many political reasons, he is not able to promote his machine to the society, to the knitter society. Unfortunately, he died in a poverty. After William Slee, there was a wide gap in the development of knitting machine. So 16th century to the 18th century it took actually. On 18th century, Derby frame was developed, and then Tickler frame was developed. Then later on, there was like a fast development on knitting machine. 19th century, there was introduction of a domestic knitting machine with a number of needles. We have developed like socks knitting machine. We start increasing the knitting needles also. Later on, like there was like a very huge development. Nowadays also, there is a development which has happened. Like modern knitting machine, a fully automatic knitting machine, like even a seamless garment knitting machine, like it was developed. Okay, then our next topic is hand knitting. This is the origin of knitting. Already we discussed like two needles was used to produce a knitted fabric. These two needles used to like transfer of loops. We are creating loop on one needle, the loop will be transferred to the another needle. So by the help of these two needles, a continuous knitted fabric, it can be manufactured. It was very famous, even though now it is very famous in our homemade purpose. There are two type of stitches it can be possible: knit stitches and then purl stitches. So this is the basic concept of our knitting. So next, so from this basic concept, a knitting machine was developed. The reason why the knitting machine is developed, only because of the investment cost. So the capital investment cost is very less. Already we discussed with your weft knitting machine and knitting machine and weaving. So all those positive character or all those positive attitude of knitting which will be play here. So investment cost is less, productivity is high, manufacturing cost is less, workforce is less, there is a flexible fabric, user friendly fabric, more comfort. Any kind of applications, a knitted fabric can be possible. So this is the main reason the knitting industry or the knitted fabric is got very famous. So the next topic is, so what is the requirement or what are the characteristics should our knitted fabric yarn, that is called as the supply package of our knitted fabric is yarn. Of course, we know that. So for those yarn, what is our basic character? The yarn should be very uniform. The reason why the yarn should be very uniform, the yarn which is passed through a fine needle, you have to understand, you assume that this is our needle, the yarn which is passed through the needle, so the needle should not affect, or the yarn should not affect by the do things. So yarn should be very uniform, and then the yarn should be free from defect. Defect is nothing but there should not be slips, there should not be nips, there should not be thick places, thin places, any foreign matters. That means it should be free from defects. So the yarn should be flexible. So with the help of flexible yarn, we can go with the flexible fabric. And then the yarn should be having an elasticity purpose. So how it can be possible? Because of by the help of spinning process. The yarn has to be, or the yarn must be, go through your combing process. Through that, it can be possible. And then the yarn should have enough strength. So based on that, we can create a knitted fabric in a very, very comfortable way. So this is the main characteristics of our knitted fabric yarn. Okay, that is called as a hosierian. We can say the other terminology is like hosierian. Next, we will see the classification of knitting machine. So we'll go with the classification. We have a two wide and main classification. One is weft knitting, another one is warp knitting. These two things are play a vital role. So weft knitting, we have a sub classification like circular knitting machine and flat knitting, will be seen later. So these two things are very, very, very important. We'll talk about the weft knitting alone. So weft knitting is nothing but it is like interlooping of yarn, and then warp knitting is also interlooping of yarn. But how we are interlooping? So next the thing is, weft knitting is nothing but we are interloop the yarn in a coarse-based direction. This is called as coarse-based direction. So the series of loop which is formed in a coarse-based direction. So with the help of those weft knitted fabric, we have a wide application. So what application we have? So next we can see the applications of our knits, like weft knitted fabric is, we can go with the apparel industries, we can go with the hosiery industries, we can go with the like tailor-made purpose. Any type of thing, it can be possible with the help of our weft knitted fabric. So there are so many applications is there. So next, so when we talk about the application of weft knitted fabric, we have wide applications. A complicated pattern can be made, a tailor-made garment, it is possible. Any type like garment, like casual garment, or in particularly in the foundation garment, that is called as intimate apparel, that is called inner wears, all are manufactured with your weft knitted fabric. And sports wear, nowadays sports wear are very famous, even it is called as sports textiles, it is very important. So for those purpose, we are manufacturing a specific fabric, even like a hat, like a scarf, even glove, like for knitted fabric, collars, then sweaters, all are manufactured from our weft knitted fabric. Next, the warp knitting. So warp knitting is nothing but warp knitting, like already we know that weft knitted is our coarse-based direction, warp knitting all in our whales-based direction. So the whales-based direction of looping formation is called as warp knitting. For warp knitted fabric is having very similar to our woven fabric, we'll see later. So the warp knitted structure and weft knitted structure or weft knitted fabrics are play a vital role in the concept of our knitting industry. So next, the warp knitted fabric are having wide applications like technical textiles, industrial textiles, even our apparel industries also. Now we'll see the difference between weft knitted fabric and warp knitted fabric. Already we saw about weaving and knitting. Now we will see weft knitted and warp knitted fabric. Here the knitted fabric, particularly weft knitted fabric, feed yarn will be horizontal direction, that is called force phase direction. Here the feed yarn will be vertical direction, that is called as whales phase direction. Here a weft knitted fabric, a single cone can be feed as like a supply package, act as a supply package. But here we need a beam, a small beam we need, like our weaving process. And then needles are raised individually, that is called as sequentially. So one by one all the needles will be raised. But here needles will be raised at a time. All the needles will be raised simultaneously, concurrently. And then here we are using stable fiber. Rare case we are using filament, but here we are most probably using filament. In rare case we can go with the stable fiber. Weft knitted fabrics are cheaper, warp knitted fabrics are somewhat costlier. And then most probably weft knitted fabrics we are using latch needle, but here all three type of like latch needle, bear needle, compound, we can use according to the type of machine. So next, like needle, apart from the needle, the investment cost is less. Why the investment cost is less? The preparatory process, because the supply package will be cone, but here we need a preparatory process, so automatically the investment cost is high. A pattern, suppose if we want to produce a specific fabric, we need to go with a different type of machines. But here any type of pattern, particularly the warp knitted fabric, even a single machine can be created so many variety of pattern. This is main difference. And then here the loops are not so uniform because of the looping purpose, but here the loops are very uniform. So these are all some classification of your weft knitted fabric and then warp knitted fabric. So this is the main thing. So when we combine together, there are some principles and terms we are using it. So next we are see about, or next we are going to see about the terms and principles of weft knitted fabric. While go with the terms and principles of weft knitted fabric, we can classify into two categories. One is fabric terminology, another one is machine terminology. While go with the fabric terminology, we can go and see, or we are going to deal about only the fabric. What are the character? What is happen in our fabric? That thing we are going to see. Machine terminology means what is the concept of machine. So what is happen in our machine? What is the basic principle? That is we are going to see. So we'll go with the fabric terminology. We'll talk about the loop. the shape and size of the loop. Loop is nothing but it is called as loop, like an inverted U shape, which is having two leg and one head. This is called as loop. We can so many terminology like open loop. So open loop is nothing but we have a head and then we have a tail, that is called as foot. The foot of the loop is, it will be open like this, it is called as open loop. Next concept is closed loop. We have a head and then we have a tail, automatically the loop that will be crossed, that is called as closed loop. Okay, the head portion of the loop is called as needle loop, the foot portion of the loop is called as single loop. Why it is called as needle loop? Automatically the needle loop is nothing but by the help of needle we are creating a loop. So the loop which will be created by way of needle, that is called as needle loop. Obviously the bottom portion of the loop is called as single loop. Obviously with the help of those needle and singer we can create open loop and closed loop. The closed loop concept, when we talk about the weft knitting and warp knitting, play a vital role. So weft knitting, to produce a closed loop, it is somewhat difficult, but in the case of warp knitting the closed loop is very convenient. So after the head loop, foot loop, even needle loop, single loop, from the fabric terminology we are going to see about the courses and veils. So courses is nothing but all the horizontal loops are called as courses, all the vertical loops are called as veils. So this is another two terminology. And then we'll see about the fabric, there is an appearance is there, like face and back. So technical face and technical back. Technical face is nothing but the new loop which will be come over the old loop, that is called as technical face. Automatically there will be only a head loop, like foot loop, no head loop. Technical back is nothing but the new loop which is formed under our old loop. So obviously there will be a head of the loop, there is no foot of the loop. So we'll see the fabric, there will be a V shape on our fabric. While the appearance of the fabric is V shape, it is called as technical face. The appearance of fabric is like a U shape, that is inverted U shape, it is called as technical back. So this is the another two terminologies. Then what about the stitch length? This stitch length is nothing but, so when we talk about this is our loop, this is called as stitch length. So 1 foot, we are going to start with the 1 foot to the next foot, it is called as stitch length. It can be calculated by way of course length divided by number of needles, that is total number of needles. So stitch length is going to be deal only one loop. Actually course length, course length is nothing but we have a tubular fabric which will be delivered in your weft knitted fabric. So that those tubular fabric or either it may be open width fabric from selvage to selvage or end to end, that is called as a full course. So once you ravel the end of those end, those length of the yarn, it is called as course length. Our next concept is course density, that is called as course per inch. In a predefined area, how many courses are there? This is called as course. Course 1, course 2, course 3, this is called as course. In a predefined area, how many courses are there? This is called as course density. Next, automatically, this will be the veil. So in a predefined area, how many veils are there? That is called as veil density. Next concept is stitch density. So the stitch density is nothing but in a predefined area, the needle, how many loops are forming, that is called as stitch density. So these are all the our fabric terminology, machine terminology. So while talk about the machine terminology, the main concept we have two, like one is cut and catch, next one is like a number of feeders. Cut and catch is very simple. We are using a cylinder in the knitting machine. Cut is nothing but how many number of trick plate is there in a predefined area. Say for an example, in an inch, how many trick plate is there? How many grooves is there? Cage is nothing but how many needles which will be accommodate on a particular cut, or how many needles which will be accommodate in a particular inch. That is called as cage. When we can talk about the feeder, feeder is nothing but feeding of yarn on your knitting machine. This is called as feeder. So how many feeders which will be placed on your knitting machine, on our knitting machine, this is called as number of feeders. So those feeders which will be decided by the diameter, diameter of your machine, type of fabric we are manufacturing, or what type of principle we are manufacturing, these factors which will decide the number of feeders. So these are the main terminology. Apart from this main terminology, we have another one main terminology, that is called as gating, needle gating. So the needle gating is nothing but this is comes under jersey fabric according to the type. Say for an example, we have two type of fabric in our circular knitting machine alone. One is single jersey, another one is double jersey. Single jersey is nothing but we are using a single set of needle. Double jersey is nothing but we are using two set of needle. One is set number one and set number two. A horizontal needle and vertical needle. The placement of needle is called as gating. So how we are placing needle? This is called as vertical needle, like cylinder needle. This is called as horizontal needle, like dial needle. We are placing it. This is called as needle gating. For those purpose, we have a two type of gating. One is rib gating, another one is interlock gating. So rib gating is nothing but the arrangement of needle in an adjacent site. For an example, the vertical needle which will be adjacently placed with the dial needle, this is called as rib gating. The needle that will be moved like this. Okay. So our next concept is interlock gating. So interlock gating is nothing but the needle that will be placed face to face. For those purpose, we are using an alternative size of needle. Say for an example, one long needle, one short needle. Long needle, short needle for cylinder. Again, we are using the same type in a dial. So the needle that will be faced like this. Long with the short, short with the long. This is the concept of our gating. So from these concepts, now we came to know that the basic concept of knitting. So I conclude myself, knitting is nothing but interlooping of yarn. It's a second largest manufacturing system of our fabric manufacturing industry. It's play a vital role. It's having very unique character. Application of knitted fabric is very wide. Wherever we go, we can see knitted fabric. So knowingly or unknowingly, we are using our knitted fabric. Thank you.